What's up guys, welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. I had a realization the other day that I had uploaded dozens of guides for PC streamers that want to live stream to sites like Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, using any kind of streaming software, but I've really neglected those console streamers, people that want to play games on their console and live stream those. Typically there's two different ways that console streamers can live stream. You can either live stream from the console itself using like the Twitch or the Mixer app, but the customization that you can have for your stream is somewhat limited. Really, all you can do is maybe add a webcam in a predefined location on top of your game, but that's about it. There's no real way of adding alerts for followers, subscribers, or donations. There's no way to add overlays. You can't overlay your chat or anything really like that. If you did want to add all of those fancy extras on top of your console gameplay, the only real option was to have a capture card and a gaming computer of some sort, so that you could plug in your console to the capture card and then use a normal streaming software to overlay all of those cool things on top of your live stream. But that is not only expensive, but it's also quite a complex setup. So console streamers were kind of caught in this balance of having either a super basic live stream with just gameplay and your webcam, which was obviously free if you already owned the console, versus a really expensive setup, but a setup that allowed you to have all of those extras on top of your live stream. Well, all of that ends now thanks to the new integration between something called Lightstream and Mixer. Lightstream is a cloud-based streaming software that allows you to stream from your Xbox, still adding in all of your overlays and alerts without needing a PC or a capture card at all. Now, Lightstream itself allows you to stream to any streaming platform, so Twitch, YouTube, Mixer, or Facebook. But in this video, I'm specifically going to be talking about the Xbox and Mixer integration. And remember, this all goes out live from my Xbox without any need for a capture card or even a PC to be running at all. You will need a PC or laptop of some sort to do just this initial setup where you're designing, customizing, and creating your stream, but it doesn't need to be a good computer. It just needs to have an internet connection. You could even use a school or library computer to do it, and it only ever needs to be done during this setup. Once that's done, you can completely run and manage your stream without a computer at all. The integration between Mixer and Lightstream is currently available for all Mixer partners and pros. All you have to do is head over to your broadcast dashboard on Mixer, scroll down and enable the integration, and then remember to click save first. And now that that integration is enabled, anything that you broadcast to the Mixer channel will route through Lightstream. So next thing to look at is entering into Lightstream Studio. So just click that button and authorize your Mixer account. So this is Lightstream Studio. This is where you'll arrange all of your scenes and sources for your live stream. In the middle here is your canvas. This is basically a preview of what you're going to be sending out to your stream whenever you go live. Up at the top here, we have some controls allowing you to enable or disable the integration, as well as showing some info as to whether your stream is currently live or offline. Here in the left, we have our layers or sources if you're used to previous streaming software for each scene. So this is where you'll be able to add all of those extra elements that we were talking about to your stream, things like text, images, alerts, and overlays. Bottom left here, we have our audio controls. This is where we can control how loud different sounds are. Down in the bottom, you finally have your scenes. This is where you can add additional scenes. So if you want, you know, a be right back scene or an intermission scene, as well as your gameplay scene, this is where you can add and choose which one you're displaying. And then finally over here on the right, you can pop open your Mixer chat and get a live preview of what is being broadcast. Now by default, Lightstream has already added your Mixer feed into scene one. So this feed is basically whatever you stream from your Xbox to Mixer. So in most cases, this is going to be your gameplay, or maybe this is going to be your gameplay plus your webcam. And then we're going to be adding all of the extra elements on top of that, like overlays and alerts here in Lightstream. So to start customizing how your stream is going to look, I'd recommend first firing up your Xbox so that we just get a game preview to come through into Lightstream. It's going to make positioning your overlays and elements much easier, because you don't want to have a stream design where some of your overlays are blocking important parts of the game. So fire up your Xbox and fire up a game that you think you're going to be streaming. Next, you're going to want to press the Xbox button on your controller and head across to the Broadcast and Capture tab. Click Broadcast and sign into Mixer. Now, if you have a USB webcam that you want to use for your stream, you can plug that directly into your Xbox. I'd recommend doing so. I think it makes for a more immersive and interactive stream when you can actually see the streamer that's playing the game. So I've just plugged in a cheap Logitech C920. kind of an industry standard for streaming because it's cheap, it's very good quality, and it's plug and play, so you can plug it into your computer or into your Xbox directly. So I'll come down to the camera options here, enable the camera, and just change the position, the zoom, and the pan so that my image fits nicely into the stream. Finally, you can click Start Broadcast, close the menu, and then head back over to Lightstream. And you should now see that your Xbox feed is coming through into the Lightstream Studio. So here's where the real fun begins. Now you can start to add in the overlays and alert integrations all on top of this Xbox Live feed. The first thing I'm going to do is add a webcam overlay to my live stream, just because the way that Xbox adds a webcam in, it doesn't look particularly aesthetically pleasing. I think just like a border around my webcam would integrate it a little bit better into my live stream. So to do that, all we need to do is come up here to the layers, click the green button to add a new layer, and then choose image as our media type. Now, with all overlays and alert designs, Mixer and Lightstream have actually done you a huge favor and already included a whole host of example overlays that you can see here for you to choose from and use freely if you like. Alternatively, if you want to upload your own, if you've designed some yourself, or maybe you've purchased some, like a premium pack. I personally already have many of the Nerd or Die overlays downloaded, so I'm gonna be using one of those. So if you would like to follow along exactly with the tutorial as I'm doing it, I will leave a link in the description to the overlays that I'm using. But really, you can browse through here the Lightstream and the mix overlays that they've got included, or as I'm going to do, upload my own. So I just click upload image, and then I browse to find it on my computer. Allow that to upload and then click OK. Now, if you're used to streaming or Photoshop or any of those programs, one thing that's key here is that you want to make sure that your layers are in the right order. So these layers in the top left are, if you think of them as like layers of a cake. So if you have your mixer feed above your webcam feed, then the webcam is not going to show at all because it's technically hidden by the gameplay. So you want to make sure that this webcam overlay that you have is just one above the mixer feed. That way it'll display above what your Xbox is streaming to Lightstream, and then we're gonna have a nice border. So you should see that we have a webcam border here now. What you wanna do now is reposition it, resize it so that it fits exactly around the webcam that we have from our Xbox. The next thing that I want to add to my stream is alerts, so that whenever somebody follows, subscribes, or donates to my stream, a nice little alert will show on top of my gameplay. It's a super interactive way to bring your viewers along for the ride, make them feel part of your stream, and also alert you that somebody has taken an action to interact with you. So Lightstream works with quite a few different providers for alerts. For me, I'm gonna be setting mine up through Streamlabs, a super popular alert provider. So to be able to set that up, all you need to do is firstly open up a new tab, head across to the Streamlabs website, and log in, and make sure you're logging in through your Mixer account. Next, we'll head over to Widgets and Alert Box. I'm not gonna go through all of the customization options here for setting up alerts in Streamlabs. I already have a super detailed tutorial about how you can customize and choose exactly which alerts to show. I'll leave that video linked up in the top corner, so if you want to watch that, open that in a new tab and watch that a little bit later after this video. So all we really need here from Streamlabs is to copy this widget URL and paste it back into Lightstream Studio here. Once that is pasted into Lightstream, we can go back to the Streamlabs website and use these test buttons to simulate a user action, just to make sure everything's working. So you can simulate a user following or subscribing or donating to your stream. And after you press the button, you should go back across to Lightstream Studio to see the alert hopefully showing up on top of your gameplay. Exactly as with the webcam overlay, feel free to resize and reposition this alert overlay layer wherever you would like in your stream. Now it's completely up to you to add all of those extra elements to make your stream look as professional or however you want to make it look. So things like event lists, social media handles, your mixer chat, donation goals. Remember to add additional scenes so that you don't just have your gameplay scene, you also have maybe an intermission scene to jump to whenever you're not playing games, or a be right back scene, or you know, stream starting soon scene. You can really customize the stream exactly as you want to now. Once you've finished creating all of the scenes that you want and polishing them to look exactly as you wish them to, all you have to do is make sure that the integration is turned on up in the top bar, and then whenever you stream from your Xbox, it's going to go through Lightstream, add all of these layers on top, and send that stream out to Mixer. You no longer need a PC to be turned on, or a PC at all. every time that you go live from your Xbox, it's going to be adding all of these things in automatically. If you want to be able to change scenes whilst you're streaming, you can quite easily do this from a mobile device. All you have to do is load up mixer.golightstream.com on any mobile device, and you can easily choose to switch scenes from the comfort of your couch. So hopefully now you have a really aesthetic and professional looking stream just directly from your Xbox to Mixer without any need for any capture cards or expensive PCs. Honestly, I think this is a super exciting technology. I'm curious to see where Lightstream go with the future with this, hopefully integrating more platforms and more consoles as well. But hopefully that guide has been helpful. I would like to give a massive thank you to all my patrons this month. These people here help me run this channel as my full-time job so I can keep creating tutorials like this for you guys. And if you haven't yet subscribed, I would highly recommend doing so. I've got some really exciting videos coming up in the next couple of weeks, some big announcements as well. So make sure you're subscribed with notifications on if you don't want to miss anything. Subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.